Hello friends, welcome to my channel. You can search my all educational videos for standard 8, 9 and 10 maths and science by typing Pravinesh publication in YouTube. If you have any query regarding my videos or if you have any query content, then you can WhatsApp me on my number. My WhatsApp number is 9016487991. I'll be very happy to solve your query. Friends, please watch this all the videos till end. And if you like this video, then please press the subscribe button which is given in the corner and press the bell icon so you will get all the updates. Today, I'm going to explain Standard 10, Chapter 2, Acid, Base and Salt in that Part 3. In that, from textbook topic 2.3, how strong are acid or base solution? Friends, in last two videos, that is in part 1 and part 2, we explained the solutions are acidic, basic and neutral, and that we can check with the help of litmus paper, that is universal indicator, some artificial indicator, that is phenolphthalein and methyl orange. They only suggest you that whether the given substance is acidic or basic or neutral. But how much they are acidic, what is the acidic value of that substance, or what is the basic value of that solution, that we cannot say with the help of universal indicator, that is litmus paper or phenolphthalein or methyl orange. With the help of this scale, that is called pH scale, we can say that how much the strength of the acid and base is. This scale is given by the Sorensen in 1909. This is pH. The full form of pH is protons of hydrogen, or we can say that power of hydrogen. Friends, we know that acid solution, it gives H plus ion, and base solution, they give OH minus ion. How much H plus ion they give or how much OH minus ion they give, on the basis of that, they have their pH value. Now let us understand this pH. pH, we have a two scale, that is pH and pOH. pH stands for acid and pOH stands for base. Here, the mathematical formula of pH is negative logarithm of H3O plus ion concentration to the base 10. Here friends, I have given the big bracket to the H3O plus that is used in chemistry for the ion concentration. Same as the definition of pOH, mathematical definition of pOH is negative logarithm of OH minus ion concentration to the base 10. Friends, this is not given in textbook. No need to worry about this mathematical value. This is for the highest standard. These two are only for the information. For any solution, pH plus pOH is equals to 14. So this scale ranges between 0 to 14. Here on the board, I have written 0 to 14. 0 to 7, the solution is acidic. If the pH value of the solution is between 0 to 7, then it is acidic. If it is 7 around, so that is neutral, and 7 to 14 it is basic. Friends, whenever acidic solution, the pH rate, if it is neutral, so it has green color, and basic, so that is purple blue color. Now you will ask, sir, what is this color? Do the solution have this color? Acidic solution, they have a red color, neutral green color, basic purple blue color? No. But when we add universal indicator, in acidic solution, it gives red color. In neutral solution, it will give green color. And in basic solution, it can give purple color. In the textbook, you can see that figure 2.7, pH of some common substance is shown on a pH paper. Colors are only a rough guide. You can see, in this diagram, gastric juice, it has a pH about 1.2. Lemon juice, it has pH about 2.2. Pure water or a blood, it has pH 7.4. Milk of magnesia, it has pH 10. And sodium hydroxide, it has pH about 14. Now friends, I'll ask you one question. Here we have a two value, that is pH 3 and pH 5. This value ranges between 0 to 7, so both are acidic. But out of these two, which is more acidic? So pH 3 is more acidic and pH 5 is less acidic than pH 3. pH 3 will give more H plus ion and pH 5 will give less H plus ion than the solution containing pH 3. So lesser the pH number, more acidic. Next, if the pOH of any compound or any solution is 9 and pOH is equals to 13, so which is more basic out of these two? So here pOH 13, which is nearer to 14, is more basic, and pH 9 is less basic than the pOH 13. pOH 13, it will give more OH minus ion with the comparison of pOH 9, and it will give less OH minus ion. So friends, this is a basic information about the pH. Now we will understand importance of pH in our daily life. Now friends, topic 2.3.1, importance of pH in everyday life, on your screen. Are plants and animals pH sensitive? Our body works within the pH range of 7 to 7.8. Living organisms can survive only in a narrow range of pH change. When pH of rainwater is less than 5.6, it is called acid rain. When acid rain flows into the rivers, it lowers the pH of the river water. The survival of aquatic life in such rivers becomes difficult. Friends, acid rain we know from the previous standard, that is from standard 7, 8 and 9, we know about the acid rain. If the pH of this rain is more, then it is known as acid rain and it is harmful to crop as well as monuments. What is the pH of the soil in your backyard? Plants require a specific pH range for their healthy growth. To find out the pH required for the healthy growth of a plant, you can collect the soil from various places and check the pH in the meter described below in activity 2.12. Also, you can note down which plants are growing in the ranging from which you have collected the soil. Friends, some plants they need basic solution, some plants they need acidic solution. Farmers, if they want to plant a crop which requires a basic soil, and if its soil is acidic, then what he needs to do, he needs to add some base into it so that the crop yield is better. Now, pH in our digestive system, it is very interesting to note that our stomach produces hydrochloric acid. It helps in the digestion of food without harming the stomach. During indigestion of the stomach produces too much acid and this causes pain and irritation. To get rid of this pain, people use bases called antacids. One such remedy must have been suggested by you at the beginning of this chapter. These antacids neutralize the excess acid. Magnesium hydroxide, that is milk of magnesia, a mild base, is often used for this purpose. pH change as the cause of tooth decay. Tooth decay starts when the pH of the mouth is lower than 5.5. Tooth enamel, made up of a calcium phosphate, is the hardest substance in the body. It does not dissolve in water, but is corroded when the pH in the mouth is below 5.5. Bacteria present in the mouth produces acids by degradation of sugar and food particles remaining in the mouth after eating. The best way to prevent this is to clean the mouth after eating food using toothpaste, which are generally basic for cleaning the teeth, can neutralize the excess acid and prevent tooth decay. Have you ever been stung by a honeybee? Bee sting leaves an acid which causes pain and irritation. Use of mild base like baking soda on the sting area gives relief. Stinging hair of a nettle leaves inject methanoic acid causing burning pain. So here friends, this is the use of pH in our daily life that you need to remember, and board can ask these questions in 1 or 2 marks. Now friends, topic 2.4, more about salt. Friends, we got information about acid, we got information about base. Now, acid plus base gives us salt plus water, that we understood, and that is known as neutralization reaction. Are this salt always neutral? No. That is depending on the strength of acid and base we have taken. Strong acid and strong base. If you mix strong acid as well as strong base, so that will give you neutral salt. If you take strong acid and weak base, so here acid is strong, so we get the acidic salt. If weak acid and strong base, here base is strong, so we get the basic salt. If weak acid and weak base are mixed with each other, so at that time we get the neutral salt. Friends, whenever we make the salt, at that time the strength of acid and base is important as well as their amount. Next is family of salt. Friends, I have written some salt here. NaCl, that is sodium chloride, CaCl2, that is calcium chloride, AlCl3, that is aluminium chloride. In this one, you can see that all have a chlorine common, so these are said to be chlorine family salt. Another example, NaCl, Na2CO3, Na2SO4, they all have a sodium common, so these are said to be sodium family salt. Now friends, topic 2.4.3 on your screen, chemicals from common salt. By now you have learned that the salt formed by the combination of hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide solution is called the sodium chloride. This is the salt that you use in food. You must have observed in the above activity that it is neutral salt. Sea water contains many salt dissolved in it. Sodium chloride is separated from this salt. Deposits of solid salt are also found in several parts of the world. These large crystals are often brown due to impurities. This is called rock salt. Beds of rock salt were formed when sea of biogen ages dried up. Rock salt is mined like a coal. You must have heard about Mahatma Gandhi's Dandi March. Did you know that sodium chloride was such an important symbol in our struggle for freedom? Friends, Mahatma Gandhi, he did a Dandi March. You know this topic from social science chapters. Britishers, they applied tax on salt. And for the removal of this tax, Mahatma Gandhi did the Dandi March. And Britishers, they leave out this tax. Now, common salt, a raw material for chemicals. The common salt thus obtained is an important raw material for various materials of daily use, such as sodium hydroxide, baking soda, washing soda, bleaching powder, and many more. Let us see how one substance is used for making all these different substances. Sodium hydroxide. When electricity is passed through an aqueous solution of sodium chloride, which is called a brine, it decomposes to form sodium hydroxide. The process is called chlor-alkali process, because of the products form chlore for chlorine and alkali for sodium hydroxide. In this equation, 2 NaCl plus 2H2O gives us NaOH plus chlorine gas plus hydrogen gas. Here friends, we have a two words, brine. Cold solution of sodium chloride is known as brine. Second word is given that alkali. What is the meaning of alkali? The soluble base that is in water is known as alkali. Chlorine gas is given off at the anode and hydrogen gas at the cathode. Sodium hydroxide solution is formed near the cathode. The three products produced in this process are all useful. Figure 2.8 shows the different uses of these products. On your screen, you can see the diagram 2.8. That is important products from the chlor-alkali process. You need to remember the usefulness of all the products. Now friends, some important compound in that first is bleaching powder. How we can prepare the bleaching powder? This is a chemical preparation. Calcium hydroxide, that is CaOH twice, plus chlorine gas. It will give CaOCl2 plus water, that is H2O. Here, CaOCl2 is calcium oxychloride and is known as bleaching powder. Friends, in this one, the bleaching agent is only chlorine. Calcium oxide is used to bind, or it is used to convert into usable form. Actually, bleaching agent from calcium oxychloride is only chlorine. Now its uses. Bleaching cotton and linen in textile industries. Bleaching wood pulp and clothes. Second, as an oxidizing agent. We know what is oxidizing agent from chapter number 1. Third, for disinfecting drinking water from germs, so we can use it for the drinking purpose. Now, second is baking soda. Friends, our mother, they cook food like idli, dosa, etc. In this one, we are adding some baking powder. So, this baking powder is made from baking soda. Its preparation, NaCl plus H2O plus carbon dioxide plus NH3 gives us NH4Cl plus NaHCO3, and here this NaHCO3 is baking soda. The chemical name is sodium bicarbonate or sodium hydrogen carbonate. If you heat this sodium bicarbonate or baking soda, we will get Na2CO3, which is washing soda, plus water plus carbon dioxide. Now its uses. Friends, whenever we add this baking soda into our food, for example to make idli, we need to heat this dough. So, when you heat this baking soda, it will create the washing soda plus water plus carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide is used to make that idli fluffy. But here, one more compound is created, and that is Na2CO3, which is a washing soda, which is bitter in nature. So, sometimes when you make idli or you make a cake, and if you add baking soda in it, it tastes bitter after it prepares. Why? Because we have added only baking soda, and that creates Na2CO3, which is a base, and that is bitter in taste. So now, uses of baking soda. For making baking powder, we are not using baking soda. What we are using? We are using baking powder. What is baking powder? It is a mixture of baking soda and mild edible tartaric acid. Why we add this acid? So that whatever the base created, this to neutralize each other's effect, and we will not get any bitter taste. Second use, in bakery to make bread soft and fluffy. Friends, whatever the carbon dioxide is created during this chemical reaction, it makes the bread and cake soft and fluffy. Third, ingredient in antacids. Friends, our grandparents or parents, they complaining about acidity. So at that time, they take a milk of magnesia or they take Eno fruit salt. So that is our antacids, which nullifies the effect of acid, and that is our baking soda. Fourth, use in soda fire extinguishers. Now friends, washing soda. Another chemical that can be obtained from sodium chloride is Na2CO3.10H2O, which is washing soda. You have seen above that sodium carbonate can be obtained by heating baking soda. Recrystallization of sodium carbonate gives washing soda. It is also a basic salt. In chemical reaction, Na2CO3 plus 10H2O gives us Na2CO3.10H2O. What does 10H2O signifies? Does it make Na2CO3 wet? We will address this question in the next section. Sodium carbonate and sodium hydrogen carbonate are useful chemicals for many industries process as well. Now, uses of washing soda. First, sodium carbonate is used in glass, soap and paper industry. Second, it is used in manufacture of sodium compounds such as borax. Third, sodium carbonate can be used as a cleaning agent for domestic purposes. Fourth, it is used for removing permanent hardness of water. So here friends, we understood important chemical compounds, that is bleaching powder, baking soda and washing soda. Now, topic 2.4.4, are the crystals of salt really dry? Activity 2.15, heat a few crystals of copper sulfate in a dry boiling tube. What is the color of the copper sulfate after heating? Do you notice what droplets in the boiling tube? Where these have come from? Add 2 to 3 drops of water on the sample of copper sulfate obtained after heating. What do you observe? Is the blue color of the copper sulfate restored? Friends, here in the figure 2.9, we have taken some copper sulfate crystals in a test tube, and then after we heat it over the burner. On your screen, you can see the hydrated copper sulfate, which is blue in color. Copper sulfate crystals, which seems to be dry, contain water of crystallization. When we heat the crystals, this water is removed and the salt turns white. Friends, whenever we take the copper sulfate, which is actually blue in color, you have seen on the screen, but now when we heat, it loses the water molecules and the copper sulfate turns white. Here friends, in chemistry we have a two word, one is effervescence and second one is efflorescence. Now friends, as I said two words, effervescence and efflorescence. What is the meaning of effervescence? There is liberation of gas. In chapter 1 or in 2 we understood that there are some gases created during chemical reaction, so that process is known as effervescence. What is efflorescence? Before that we understand the meaning of water of crystallization. Friends, in nature there are few substances, they capture water molecules from the nature and they become hydrated. Actually we are not sprinkling water on them, but automatically they capture water molecules from the nature, and this water molecules present in the compound is known as water of crystallization. For example, when we eat mamra or a papad in this season, that is in monsoon season, so it becomes foggy after some time. Why they becomes foggy? Because they captures water molecules from the nature. So when you again heat or reheat this papad or mamra, they again lose these water molecules and they become crispy. So removal of this water of crystallization is known as efflorescence. Same as in this activity, whenever the copper sulfate, that is CuSO4, copper sulfate is blue in color, its formula is CuSO4, but when it contains water molecules from the nature, it has 5 molecules. Every compound, it has capacity to capture water molecules. Copper sulfate can capture up to 5 molecules of water from the nature, and this is hydrated copper sulfate which is blue in color. Same as Na2CO3, that is washing soda, it can contain up to 10 molecules of water from the nature. And removal of this water molecules, that is water of crystallization, is known as efflorescence. If you moisten the crystal again with water, you will find that the blue color of the crystals reappear. Water of crystallization is a fixed amount of water molecules present in the one formula unit of a salt. 5 water molecules are present in one formula unit of copper sulfate. Chemical formula for hydrated copper sulfate is CuSO4.5H2O. Now you would be able to answer the question whether the molecule of Na2CO3.10H2O is wet. One other salt which possesses water of crystallization is gypsum. It has 2 water molecules as water of crystallization. It has the formula CaSO4.2H2O. Let us look into the use of this salt. Plaster of Paris. On heating gypsum at 373 Kelvin, it loses water molecules and becomes calcium sulfate amihydrate, that is CaSO4.5H2O. This is called Plaster of Paris. The substance which doctor use as a plaster for supporting fracture bones in the right position. Plaster of Paris is a white powder, and on mixing with water it changes to gypsum once again, giving a hard solid mass. Chemical reaction CaSO4.5H2O plus 1.5H2O gives CaSO4.2H2O, which is gypsum. Note that only half a water molecule is shown to be attached as a water of crystallization. How can you get half a water molecule? It is written in this form because 2 formula units of CaSO4 share 1 molecule of water. Plaster of Paris is used for making toys, materials, for decoration and for making surface smooth. Try to find out why is calcium sulfate amihydrate called Plaster of Paris. Here friends, we know Plaster of Paris. Why it is known as Plaster of Paris? Because it was invented or made in Paris. Now friends, I will explain chapter 2 in 3 parts, that is part 1, part 2, part 3. Now you need to read the whole chapter from the textbook, underline important words, try to remember each and every chemical equations in this chapter, do BBQ, that is blue box question, and exercise. And if you have any doubt, then you can WhatsApp me on my number. My number is 9016487991. Thank you.